That's the first time I've ever seen one man shoot another man in the back just to protect himself. And I just stood there.
John, you're just upset from seeing a man killed.
Mr. Vail, I saw too many men killed in the war for just one more to upset me. Oh, no, no. There's something big building up in this valley. In the army, we used to call it enemy pressure. First, Wilkinson's brother Cole comes back from Texas to help him run anchor. Then a tough kid with a fancy gun shows up on the Wilkison payroll. And all the small ranchers are forced out one by one. Anchor riders tearing up the fences, stampeding, shooting.
Well, you gotta expect that in cattle country.
Yes, but the farmers to the south of me are getting the same kind of pressure, the same kind of offers, practically nothing for their land. Now Mahoney's out, the sheriff's dead, and I'm invited to anchor to talk business.
You mean Mr. Wilkison wants to buy your place? Oh, that's wonderful, honey. We can get married and go east right away.
You can't deal with a man who sends six killers to shoot an old man in the back.
But that has nothing to do with us.
Of course not. You can't let that stand in the way of Caroline's happiness and yours.
Wilkison's the only one here who can afford to pay you a decent price.
Doesn't give him the right to push people around.
You can't argue with a man who started with a few acres of land and now owns practically the whole valley. You must go see him.
Please, John. For us.
I'm sorry, Carolyn. I just can't. I better be getting back to my place.
Aren't you staying overnight?
Oh, I want to make sure my men don't get into any trouble. I got a couple of hotheads who'd like nothing better than to take a shot at a Wilkison rider.